Hey, this is WhyBeAre with BeamNG Drive, and today we're going to be taking a look at a mod called the Genesis F2. And as you can kind of guess, this is a Formula 2 car, and there are basically two configurations. There's a 2020 version and then a 2018 version, with the only real difference being the size of the wheels. So you have the small wheels on the 2018 and then the big wheels on the 2020. We also have a wide selection of paint jobs, and the one that appeals to me most is pink car. It stands out. All the other colors, they look like a boring old race car, but pink car could be anything. It could be made out of Pepto-Bismol for all I know. So looking at the car, it does look just like you'd expect it to look like. It looks like a Formula 2 car. We have a bunch of camera angles available to us, one of which is the interior camera, and I love the steering wheel on this thing because it has all the information you could want. But if you drive like a maniac, you'll have no idea how fast you're going. How fast am I going now? I don't know, but it's pretty fast probably. We're fine. Yeah, you're probably not going to drive like that anyways, but it's just kind of funny that you can't see how fast you're going if you steer back and forth too fast. So if a cop pulls you over and they say, do you know how fast you're going? No, I was all over the place, officer. I don't know how fast I was going. And in addition to camera angle, we also have the action cam, which gets us above the halo, which is kind of nice. You don't have that block in your view. If I was just driving the car, that's probably the one I would use. We also have the side pod cam, which looks really cool because you can see the suspension moving as we go, and you kind of see the front wing moving as well. It's just a really dynamic camera angle, but it's not easy to drive from, so we're going back to the original Orbit camera. Here's another neat thing about this car. It has a ton of pieces to it that can all fall apart. So to demonstrate that, we're going to go to fun stuff, make sure we're going fast enough, not yet, and brake. And you just see a ton of pieces flying all over the place. I can't even count how many pieces there are. There are so many. And one of the neat things about this thing is the whole rear has completely detached from the front. And then there is the engine, which is actually a structural element. You can see here how all of this is still held together because it's one giant unit of engine and suspension, which is really cool to look at. And then some of the other parts that are around here, we have one of the side pieces of the vehicle there. We have the engine covering piece, and then just a bunch of small pieces as well, like this tiny carbon fiber bit, maybe for aerodynamics, another maybe carbon fiber bit. I don't know what those are. Over here, we have the big piece, though. That's the whole underside of the car, basically. And it's so lightweight because, again, it's made out of carbon fiber. There's carbon fiber everywhere with this thing, basically, I assume. But all these pieces all over the place is just really neat to look at. And I guess I gotta answer the question, though. What does it look like when you do a normal crash? We're gonna do just that, smashing into the wall about 120, 130 miles per hour, and we can drive along the wall. Yeah, this is actually working perfectly well. That's how Formula One cars drive. All right, I think that's enough of doing nonsense, so we can take a look at the damage, actually. So the vehicle itself is very strong, doesn't really get deformed, but it drops pieces everywhere. So we go along some, we'll find some more. So I just passed one up. There's a piece that fell off, just a little pink piece in the shadows. Over here, we have another piece. Going here, there's the front wing of the vehicle, it looks like. Like, we just have pieces everywhere. Now let's focus on how this thing drives, because this is interesting. This is the only car I've ever had in this game where it feels like it would be beneficial to drive with a steering wheel, because it drives like it's on a rail, but it's also very, very twitchy. So what ends up happening is when you use the controller, you have like 2 inches of movement to do all your steering, and that is just not quite precise enough to properly drive this thing fast. If you had a wheel, you would have like 2 feet of steering distance, and that would make it so easy to do just the exact amount of steering you need to go through the corners as fast as possible. We drove good? How about a little crash now? Ooh, we got some air time, and then we are upside down. But I think we can still drive this thing, so we'll get it back onto its wheels and continue going if it'll let me. Yeah, it kind of works. It's all bouncing all over the place, and steering is bad. And you can see just how messed up the suspension is looking at the front wheels just going all over the place. Apparently, we're going 100 miles per hour before we smack that thing. And again, we ended up upside down. How do you keep doing that? All right, we're going to flip this thing over. Check this out. Flipping maneuver. It actually did like a whole roll. Okay. Regular flipping maneuver. And you notice the vehicle itself doesn't really get damaged. It's very, very strong. So instead, you just have lots of parts that fall all over the place, including the wheels, which means, yeah, we can't drive. And while we're talking about wheels, how about we show the difference between the 2020 and the 2018 wheels? So on the 2020, which I'm just spawning up now, it has nice big wheels. On the 2018, it has small wheels. And the easiest way to notice the difference is look at the sidewall of the tire. This one has a massive sidewall. And over here, this one looks like a normal sports car tire in terms of how thick the sidewall is. This one, it almost looks like an off-road vehicle. It's so thick. Okay, it's not that thick, but you get the point. Now, as for driving, I really don't notice a significant difference between the two tires. I'm sure it makes some difference, but it's not noticeable because the handling is still amazingly good. So let's drive this thing for around a bit until we can get to a nice, big, fat straightaway, and then we'll do a high-speed impact. And I hope we can go about 150 miles per hour at least for the impact. I want to get eventually also a 200 mile per hour impact, but for that we might need to go to a place that has really big wide open roads to make sure we can actually achieve those speeds. So the straightaway is coming up right here, and I'm a little all over the place as I'm driving. I apologize about that. But here's the important part. How fast can we go? Come on, like 150-ish, 140. Yeah, that was like 150-ish. Perfect. And what an explosive crash. So you can see, it is very, very strong. Even at over 100 miles per hour, it mostly maintains its shape, but all of the pieces do end up falling off. So we just got a bunch of debris all over the place over on the right side. There's not much actually on the left side. It's kind of funny. The way we crashed, everything just goes over in that direction for some reason, I guess. And by the way, this is the Tasty Cola vehicle. I didn't mention that earlier, but this is probably the best color scheme on the 2020s, and this is the best color scheme on the 2018s. So we got the best of both worlds right here. And as we're switching between the two cars, you probably noticed there are two buttons in the top. One says pit limiter, the other says DRS switch. So if we turn on the pit limiter, it'll limit our speed to 35-ish miles per hour. So I am flooring it, trying to go as fast as I possibly can, but the pit limiter says no. This is max speed for the pits. If you try to floor it from zero to pit speed, this is what it looks like, by the way. You go vroom, and then up, I hit pit speed. Like, it looks so dramatic, and then you just stop accelerating. But you can turn that off, and then you actually start accelerating, and it accelerates hard, so you gotta be careful if you just turn it off while you're already flooring it, like I did there. In addition to that, we also have DRS. So you can see the wing moving up and down as we turn DRS on and off. So it just changes the aerodynamic profile of the vehicle, making it better for different situations. One thing that's kind of neat about the DRS is if you have it enabled and you slam on your brakes, it'll automatically disable, because it's ideal to have it disabled when you're slowing down. So I tried to do it right there, but I didn't exactly slow down properly, so it's enabled. And then we hit the brakes and it turns off automatically. So it's cool seeing the wing automatically transition from mode to mode as we're driving along. So here's another example, disabled and then going around the corner. And we have almost completed a lap, so why don't we just finish up this lap and do an actual lap of the place, which could quite possibly be the fastest lap I have ever done around Hirochi Raceway. That was stupid fast. Except, oh no, there's a car in the way. Don't want to hit them. Or did I want to hit them? I know a lot of you guys out there like, YBR, I wanted to see you crash into him. So, you know what? We can do that as well. But come on now, if you set something up like that, everybody knows that's what's coming next. It is so predictable. But y'all like predictable, so here we go. 8x slow-mo, and we're gonna make sure we at least get a nice camera angle on this, so freeze physics, and then the manual camera comes out. Line it up right there, and boom, track the crash. Excellent camera work, if I do say so myself. Then we'll go back to the car, and we'll let it kind of bounce around until it eventually, hopefully, lands on its wheels, which it actually did. Awesome. Can it drive? Not really. Like, steering is just a suggestion, and it doesn't like to listen to you. Okay, how about the pink car? It has some drivability to it, but it's all messed up in the rear, so it can't put down the power properly. So if you try to accelerate, actually, you're just gonna spin out forever. All right, I think that's gonna do it for this racetrack. So let's swap racetracks. We're gonna go to the racetrack on automation test track. And now I wanna drive around this track with the AI, because there are actually two versions of the vehicle made specifically for the AI to use, because they equipped it with electronic stability control and traction control to make it easier for them to drive, but they don't have any paint jobs on those versions. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna spawn them up, give them good paint jobs, and then we'll have a bunch of AI cars to drive with that all look cool. Also, as an added bonus, if you want to be lazy and make this car handle stupid good, you use the AI version as well, and then you don't even feel like you need a racing wheel. But anyways, I'll be back once we've got a bunch of cars ready to go. All right, so I spawned up one of every color, and then I chose my favorite color and put the AI to traffic mode. So they're not going to be driving super fast, but it'll at least feel like we're racing through traffic, which should be fun to do. Although they are quite a way ahead of me. There, we finally got some AI showing up. And we're going to like swerve between them, do all kinds of dramatic stuff to keep it as interesting as possible. Can't swerve between them here, though. There's just so many of them just in a line, basically. Oh, those two just crashed. Oh, they almost took me out. I think they touched me a little bit, but I still feel like I drive fine. This is actually really nice driving through the traffic like this. I don't know why I don't do this more often. This is just fun. Like, yeah, we're passing them every few seconds, but it's still a challenge to make sure you don't accidentally crash into them. And are those guys, oh, what? Those guys are driving the wrong way down the road. Those idiots. Most of the time, traffic mode works decently on racetracks. Every now and then you get that. So we'll go ahead and try this again, but this time, I'm gonna be the idiot. I'm gonna be the one that goes in the opposite direction. So this is like traffic mode on extra hard because you just have cars coming at you non-stop, basically. What? He attacked me. What the heck? And he just drives off like there was nothing. Wow. Okay, that was on me. That one was on me. I blocked that dude. And it is not really driving well. And I actually took that guy's whole front of his car, if you notice that. So since this thing isn't driving great, we'll just go ahead and say, get me a brand new one, and then we can keep doing the stupid stuff. But instead of trying to avoid them, yeah, we just slam into them. We don't care anymore. Can we still drive? Heck yeah, we can still crash then. Hit that guy, hit the other guy too. Yeah, just have a pile of cars. This is beautiful. Pile of cars. That guy's literally on top of the other dude. Oh my goodness gracious. What a mess. But as I'm doing this, you get a great view of all the different paint jobs in slightly deformed states. But I do want to let you see them in a not deformed state as well. So let's do regular driving time where you can see them intact as we're driving by them. So this is a very realistic vision of what you would see. What is going on, guys? I know I just said I wanted to show you with them intact, but come on. You put a ball of cars in front of me, that is too tempting. I gotta smash into it. Yep, now I'm part of the ball of cars. Part of the party, man. Yeah, we're actually slowly moving forward along the racetrack. Somehow, we are technically racing, but that's just too slow. So we're gonna get out of there and do what I said a second ago, which is show you what it looks like when you're driving by them. And also, I see some of them in pit lane. It actually feels like they're using the pit lane speed, which is kind of nice, I bet. Because it seems like that's what they're doing sometimes here, but there's really not much you can do to make them drive faster. Those guys just crashed. Oh no, I got so distracted. I wasn't paying attention to my driving and I crashed. Stupid AI distracting me. We gotta have at least a little bit of good driving, right? Well, we had some good at the start until the other guy came from the wrong direction. Like that guy, maniac, says the guy who was also doing that not 2 minutes ago. All right, just a little bit of good driving, and then we'll try something else. So nice swerving through traffic. Don't hit them, and pass. Oh, little impact. We're okay, I don't think it affected my car. Yeah, it feels like it's driving fine. Oh, we got a crash up front. Avoid the crash. This is proper racing if everybody you were driving against was 10 times slower than you. Either way, I actually think this is one of the better ways to play this game. This is great because you actually feel like you're doing something. Whoop, losing control a little bit. Well, losing control is doing something, so that counts. That's legal. Swerving, getting through traffic. And try to get to the outside. Excellent. Oh my goodness, everybody's going the wrong way. Ooh, that's dangerous. I don't know how I survived going through that one. All right, here we go. Oh, that guy just swerves into me. And now my tires are blown and this is my top speed. Y'all gonna hit me, I'm gonna hit y'all. How dare you? I could kind of drive still somehow after that, considering that was like 130 mile per hour impact, I think. Not very well, mind you, because I just slammed into the wall accidentally, but we had some driving. All right, so this car is done. That's what it looks like. And then we'll reset the car and we're gonna get rid of all of the traffic because I no longer need it. And I wanna do a high speed test to compare the difference between DRS on and DRS off. To do that, we need to go to the big straightaway though. Also, one thing I should mention is even if you have the electronic stability control and the traction control on, you can still spin this out. For example, just do a little aggressive maneuver like that where you whip it around and it will spin out. And I don't think I caused any damage to it when I did that. I think we just barely did touch the wall. That was actually a really nice, controlled spin out. And it would have been a lot faster if I just reset where I was, but I already hit the button. It was too late now. And I enjoy driving this car, so it's fine if we have to drive to the destination, because this really does drive like no stock car. There is no stock car that comes close to this kind of speed in a track like this. So here will be the starting point for the races. We'll do the first run with the DRS disabled. So with it disabled, that should give us a lower top speed. And we'll also compare the speed that we enter the bridge, which is about 158 miles per hour. And then we're gonna watch what's our top speed. It's about 182 before we had to corner a little bit. And then still accelerating as much as we can. It's just touching 186 miles per hour before big impact. And big impact and do a grind. Oh yeah, Tony Hawk Pro Skater up in this thing. Parts going everywhere, and we're gonna go ahead and flip it upright, and once again, very, very strong, basically indestructible structure on this thing. You're not gonna break it like that. So this time, we're gonna do DRS enabled, which should allow us a little bit more speed. First, we compare the speed when we enter the bridge, so that is 163 miles per hour. That's 5 miles per hour faster, and it does feel like it's topping out higher because we are touching just under 190 miles per hour, which we did not do before. So it does make a difference in this situation, so that's cool. Now, time for destruction. And because of the way the controls are set for this thing, it's kind of difficult for me to properly do slow-mo the way I normally would, so we have to use the keyboard and stuff. It's a little bit messy, but once everything is lined up, it should be good to go. And it's lined up, the camera is ready. Smash that car right into the wall. Got a lot of pieces going all over the place. Beautiful crash. Exactly what I was looking for. It looks just like the last one, basically, except you could actually see what was happening this time. Isn't that nice? And I'll let it go a little bit more in 100 times slow-mo because it's still kind of making impact with the rear. And then we can go ahead and start to speed things up a little bit right now. Go back to more regular slow motion speeds, and we'll watch this guy with a little bit of manual work as he does yet another awesome grind. That's why they have that bottom plate be nice and flat. It's so it can grind on the walls easier. Okay, that's probably wrong. All right, so that's gonna do it for this map. Now we need to do the driving upside down test, and the easiest place to do that at is grid map. First, we need to make a tube to drive through, so we'll go into the map editor with F11. And then we're gonna fly over to one of the tubes that already exists. How convenient is that? And we're just gonna bring him up into the air and then also make him much, much bigger. So we'll use the scale key and then just make him super duper long so we can get up to speed and then try to get upside down all inside of the tube nice and easily. I'm gonna keep it the same in terms of the other dimensions though, because I know it'd be really difficult to try to make it where it's still a circle. We need a nice even circle to be able to transition from top to bottom as smooth as we possibly can. So now we'll go ahead and bring the camera into the tube, and then we'll change the pickup truck into a Formula One car. So we set it right here, and then we're gonna go, oh, did you see where that tailgate popped off? That was kind of neat, look at that. Ha! I don't know why that's so amusing to me. One last time. Oh, it just pops off so cleanly. Anyways, Genesis F2, we'll grab just anyone. This one looks kind of nice. And now let's see, can it drive upside down or not? Well, first things first, let's get it aligned with the tube properly. Okay. And we will accelerate up to speed. We'll go about 180 miles per hour and then try to flip over. That should be fast enough where if it's gonna hold onto the ceiling, it'll do it at that speed. So there is 180 and we're still accelerating a bit, but just go to the ceiling and see what happens. And would you look at that? It actually works. We are holding onto the ceiling perfectly. And you can tell it's not gonna last because the engine is starved to boil. Eventually the engine will die, but we're holding onto the ceiling at 190 miles per hour. That is some downforce. And even at like 150, it's still holding on. 140, about 130 is the bare minimum speed it looks like to hold onto the ceiling, which is impressively slow, actually. That's kind of crazy. Let's try to drive on it at like 150 and see if that actually works, if we just had a lot of momentum going for it still. So second gear, third gear, fourth gear. And then, actually, if we just hold it in fourth gear, that probably puts us at Yeah, 150-ish. That's pretty good. So let's see. Does 150 work? Yep. We are upside down. That is amazing. Although I am pulling a little bit to the side when I try to drop to like 140. So probably about 140 is where it gets a little tough. And then while engine starts to overheat, that makes it a lot tougher. While we're here, we can go ahead and see, can the vehicle naturally reach 200 miles per hour? Because that was something I haven't got to test yet. So we'll just go ahead and floor it down the tube and see what happens. And through this whole thing, we've had the DRS in full downforce mode, which obviously makes it easy to grab onto the top of the tube. For a high speed run, put it to low downforce mode so we can get to a higher speed, hopefully. So there's 191, 2, 3, 4, mod 5, it seems like it's topping out right about here. 195, 6, we ain't gonna get higher than 6, are we? Yeah, because it's still bouncing back to 5, so it's not really getting any faster. If we had a 10-mile tube, maybe, because we'll eventually lose some weight by running out of fuel and stuff, but that's pretty much topped out. Also, you can still probably drive upside down even with it in the other downforce mode. Yeah, it doesn't make too big of a difference for driving upside down. 150-ish still seems to work. 140 even works some. 130 is actually working. Wow. This thing might have the most aggressive aero of any car I've seen in this game to be able to do something like that. Absolutely amazing amounts of downforce. It'll probably be interesting to see how this thing flies if we go over to Leap of Death. And for Leap of Death, big wheels, small wheels, I don't think it really matters. So we're just going to go with a random one. Which one did I pick? I picked the orange one. That one's actually kind of cool looking. All right, so here we go. We're actually able to get a decent amount of traction through here, going about 75 miles per hour off of the jump. But with all the aerodynamics on this thing, I'm really curious how well it'll fly through the air. And the answer is surprisingly well. Uh-oh, but it's getting a little crooked. And then once it gets crooked, it really starts to dip down. And when it dips down, that's when you're going to get the big impact. Oh, it's upside down flying. No, this makes no sense. This makes no sense. What? Just a while ago, I said, wow, that's the first time I've ever seen a car fly into the water. This is the first time I've ever seen a car fly over the water. And it legitimately looked like it was just going to fly forever. You know what that means, right? We need to see what happens when you actually try to fly it like a plane and not just have it coincidentally fly. So we're going to do the same thing as last time, just driving off a leap of death. And I guess if we hold left or right, it might tip over a little bit faster. Hold the brakes, thumb. Eventually, it'll get upside down. I mean, I managed to last time, right? Come on. And then, is it upside down enough? Okay, it is now starting to fly. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go back up to the top of Leap of Death. And we can go ahead and do camera speed at maximum to get there nice and fast. Drop the camera speed back down to a more normal amount. And we teleport it here. And just let's watch how it actually flies. So it levels out a bit. And then it looks like it's going straight. And can it actually hold that for a significant amount of time? Yeah, it can legitimately just fly in a straight line for a good long time before it starts to lose height. This is basically a glider when it's upside down. That is crazy. And then once it starts to level out again, we bring it back up to the top so it can gain speed again. Oh no, it's gonna crash now. Nope, not on my watch. Hold, and fly! Fly! Yeah! Oh, that is amazing. Well, I think that's going to do it for this video. Until next time, this has been WhyBeAre. And remember, if you like or dislike this video, I will know. I can tell by how well the car flies. So do the right thing, and I'll see you next time. Also, just so you guys know, I will let this thing actually fall down Leap of Death and get damaged because I know a lot of you guys like to see that, so here it is as well. Although, we do have those little cars off to the side, which are covering things up just a little bit if I remember to add them, which I've been doing pretty good at. But either way, the car is in the middle of the screen, and you can see everything else, probably. I don't know why I'm still talking.